1, 2, 3, 4. You have to end on a one, so boom. Yes, perfect, there it is. What's up everyone and welcome to Metal Morning...
11, 12?
Welcome to Metal Morning. sorry, we... Damn it, we... I'm sorry. We didn't plan ahead for to perform a song, so we just jammed out in the beginning there. And it's the first time I see my wife with a five-string bass. It's kind of hot, just
you,
saying.
Have any suggestions on what to play next time, please?
Please put a suggestion in the comment section of what to play next time, and we'll be incredibly happy.
Let's maybe just say something that. Not that
hard.
Hard for on bass? Me, as I am not an experienced bass player.
So something easy.
Something easy.
Maybe not Primus. Let's just say that. Welcome everyone. Hope you're having a great morning. It's a Sunday morning. We have a couple of things to talk about today, and we're gonna review two albums. It's become a thing now where we review albums. I think it's people enjoy watching us review
I hope so.
Albums. We've been incredibly busy this week. The website has been really busy. Last time we did a bundle, that thing is still going and we sold a bunch. We also started our new t-shirt printing thing. So, and the impulse responses too. So we had a lot of traffic on our website, which was the point when we started the metal bundle thing. We wanted people to go to the website and buy shit.
And they did.
So we really appreciate that. Some people out there say that I've sold out now. That I'm talking so much about our merch. So there's one guy, he left.
Like, left for...
No,
like
he said like,
unsubscribe?
Oh, Ola's selling himself out now. See you, goodbye.
Okay.
I don't know how...
Okay. Sorry.
Very sad. Sad story. He left. This guy.
Should have had a ceremony or something.
Celebrate? Maybe, I don't know. No, but... just want to say thank you so much for all the support. It's really cool and it makes us work. So that's a good thing. Everyone has to pitch in when we start, printing t-shirts. We have no idea how to print t-shirts, but we're doing it anyways. And, you know, they're turning out really good. This t-shirt I have on right now, I printed that this morning.
Today, freshly.
Yes,
from
it's
the
freshly
printer.
Made for myself. And
where
this
is it
show.
From?
It's Hollow Knight. It's a game that I played a lot of. I love it. Waiting for Silksong. Oh, dorks. I'm referring to myself as a dork because that's a sequel. Okay, the news.
You should teach me how to play that.
Like, I would love you long time if you learned to play the Seinfeld intro. Like,
oh, isn't that very...
No, you can. You'll nail that. Give it a couple of weeks, you'll be able to play it. No problem.
It's a challenge.
No. It's a challenge for you. What?
Okay, the Seinfeld intro.
I have a real hard time to concentrate because she's eating on that half ball. We have to check out the new Slipknot song. There's a new Slipknot song. It's called The Chapel Town Rag. There's not really that much to see except this visual thing right here. But it's pretty cool. Rap?
It's coming.
The rap is coming.
Yeah, it's coming.
It sounds like Slipknot.
It does.
Motherfucker, check. That's a thing you have to have in a Slipknot song.
I
I'm just waiting for the chorus. That's where I decide if it's a good song or not.
Okay.
Maybe this is the chorus, by the way.
Not bad.
It's not bad. It's Slipknot. Okay.
Feels like the song is far away.
The song is far away.
Yeah, the other song was closer.
Which song?
There.
Oh, the vocals, you mean?
This, yeah, the vocals. Here it's here, but the other one was somewhere in the end of the tunnel.
I don't know, I felt like this is Slipknot, but the chorus is almost too much Stone Sour, maybe, which is, you know, the other band, which is calmer. Maybe a little bit too calm for Slipknot, or they're just trying, I don't know what they're trying, but it's a little too, the chorus was a little bit too chorusy. If you understand what I'm saying. It's not bad. You know, I don't know. The chorus doesn't sound like Slipknot to me. Let's just say that. It's not that it's bad. It's good. There's a lot of things happening in this song.
Okay.
All right. That was Slipknot's new song. What did you think?
It's a good song.
It's a good song.
I mean, it's a lot of things happening, but it's not bad. It's angry. It's melodic. It has everything.
That's the point, though. I feel like it's trying to have everything in it.
Yeah.
But and it's a new single, so
maybe too much.
Maybe a
little too much.
Too
many ingredients.
Too many ingredients. Maybe there's just too many chefs in the band. There are 9 people after all. Yeah. I don't think they all like contribute to the songwriting. But there's a lot of things happening, in my opinion. The chorus was good. Is it Slipknot?
And you were too old for this shit.
I'm too old for this shit, man. No. I love Slipknot. Maybe the chorus was a little too soft for me.
Yeah.
You know, it's a little too soft for Death Melola. Let's just say that. Okay? But then we have another piece of news from a newly formed band, The Halo Effect, which is the members from Early in Flames. Michael Stanne of Dark Tranquillity and, you know, Jesper Strömblad and a bunch of Early in Flames members. And we can finally listen to a song, Shadow Minds. Let's listen. What is it? I'm a little excited hearing. Are they taking on the old In Flames sound? Or are they doing something like new?
I wouldn't tell because I haven't listened that much to
No, In Flames. Old In Flames, okay. Or In Flames? I think it sounds like In Flames. Now, does it sound like the old In Flames or the new In Flames? I think it sounds more like the new In Flames. It might be just the production, but I think what they're trying to do is that when Jesper left In Flames the first time there in 2010 or 2008, something like that, he felt that they were losing the grip of what In Flames are. And maybe they're trying to bring that back with this, because this sounds like it. Sounds like a flame. I mean, I've heard this before, in a way, right? I mean, I love the vocals. Mika Stanne, love his shit. Riffs are great. Maybe I just expected a little bit more, something more different. It's a little safe, maybe. I mean, this is just In Flames 2, basically. Not saying it's bad, okay? It has all the leads, all the licks, and all that shit that's like common In Flames, but chorus is good, man. I think the song is good. I've heard In Flames before, as I said. This is In Flames 2, basically, but with Mikael Stanne back on vocals. He was on the first In Flames album. Yeah, I guess a lot of people will be happy.
Yep.
Right?
Good.
Good.
Good for them.
It is good for them. I just want to check out this really cool riff. It's going to be on the list of albums we review later.
Okay.
But I want to see, we're going to talk about Limp Bizkit. Calm down. Limp Bizkit's the shit, okay? There's a new riff and they released an album just now, Still Sucks, that one of us are going to review.
Yep.
And there's a really cool riff that I think is just really, really good. And Wes is showing how to play it. Let's look at him play this riff.
Thanks.
I think Wes is an incredible talent in the band. Very underrated guitar player. He deserves a lot more credit, in my opinion. That's great tone, great sound, and he seems like a really cool dude. Let's just say that. That's a fucked up riff.
I mean, taken without...
with any context?
Without context is... just craziness.
It's a little sloppy, but that's basically
it. It looks like he has no idea what he's doing, but I think it looks fucking, I have to try that riff. Maybe a challenge for me. You learn Seinfeld bass, I learn that riff. And that, my friends, was the news. We didn't talk about Vince Neil. That's a good thing. That means that we had okay news, and I'm excited about Slipknot and Halo Effect. But now we're going to talk about album reviews. And we're okay. All right. Album reviews, great.
Yes.
Last time, we gave Luis the task to review the new Dream Theater album. It's called A View from the Top of the World.
Yeah.
Okay, do you want to go first or you want me to go first?
Yeah, I can go first. I was hoping that I would have the chance to listen to it more, but I usually listen to music when I work out.
Yes.
And last week I was sick, so I didn't work out. So there was less opportunities.
But we listened to the album in the car.
We listened to it in the car, yes. And yesterday I was on the gym. And it's a Dream Theater album. I mean, they're never bad. My first thought was that it's kind of safe.
Yes.
It's nothing like out of the box or something. It's
maybe
very
that
safe.
They're using 8 strings. That's like the thing of the album. That John Petrucci is using an 8 string.
For me, that is no difference.
Yeah,
but
exactly.
It's a good album. I mean, if you're tired of the older albums, then you can listen to this one because it's new, but it's nothing else.
No, it's for the fans.
It
basically.
Is, it's for the fans. So if you like Dream Theater, you will like this album.
Yeah.
The only thing I was hoping for was to have something a little bit outside of the box.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Like, they have some albums with more of a theme, like atmosphere in some of the songs. And it was, I was kind of missing that.
Mm-hmm. Can I give my little review as well? Because I've been also been listening to the album, obviously. There's nothing that differentiates the songs between the albums anymore, in my opinion. Like, on the older albums, maybe this is because we're old. And, you know, the earlier albums were more important, but I feel like in this case, there's a lot where they do the technical parts, where they play a lot of ding 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 ding, and you know, this syncopated drums and keyboards and whatnot. It's like they've done that, and it seems like sometimes they're doing it because they have to, you know, to be technical. While, you know, you go back to, just as an example, like 6 Degrees of In the Turbulence, where I thought was, you know, filled with their like individual songs, individual hits. Now it's like it's all mashed up in a little bit. Some of the songs can just flow together. I don't know if that was the plan, but there's not as many songs that are like super catchy and it's like, this is the song I want to listen to.
Yeah.
There was one song, what was the name of that
song? Yeah, The Call, what was it called? Answering the Call?
Answering the Call, yes. I think that was my favorite.
Yeah.
Because it was the one that had like...
was a little bit different from the other.
It was a little bit different. Maybe it was a little bit more radio friendly. Maybe? Or it just... It had a little bit more of a hit factor.
Yeah.
Let's just say that. That's just my opinion. Sometimes, like, they released Liquid Tension Experiment earlier this year.
Yeah.
I think some of the parts there are like... it could be the same thing. Like, the technicality is like, sometimes it's technical just to be technical. Not that I don't mind that, but it's, you know, it's kind of like the same a little bit over and over. I know new fans will like it, and, you know, I enjoy the album.
Yes, but, it's a good album.
It's a good album, but maybe it's just us getting old, man. We're just expecting more a little bit. We're just not as impressed anymore.
No,
I think that's the problem.
Hard to impress.
So what would you rate this album?
I don't know. For a one that has been listening to Dream Theater, it would be a 6 out of 10.
Yep.
But if I never heard Dream Theater before, maybe a 7 out of 10.
Okay.
Because...
so you think it's a new stepping stone for a new listener to the band?
Yeah, I guess they would appreciate it more than maybe the hardcore Dream Theater fan.
Okay.
That's just my guess.
Interesting. There it is. Luis review view of the top of the of world. Me and the album names and song names are the worst. All right, so what have I been reviewing? I've been reviewing the new and upcoming Exodus album, Persona Non Grata. And it's out the 19th of November, and now it's before. So, you know, oh, newsflash. Exodus, part of the Big Five, the fifth band of the Big Four, you know?
The little brother of the Big Four.
Well, you know, Scott Ian just said the other day that, you know, he wants the Big Four to be extended to Big Five and include Exodus, because Exodus are underrated, or like they should be on the list because they were early and they pushed the boundaries early.
Yeah, but then there's going to be more bands then.
I know, Testament, for instance. Testament has to fit in there somewhere. But Exodus is a little bit more important for the history, I would say. Okay. Gary Holt, obviously a very big force in the band, just as with every other Exodus album. It's just a pure pleasure to listen to his guitar tone. It's so nice, you know, to hear him, this type of production. It's you hear immediately that it's Gary Holt. It's a very, for me, like Slayer on drugs type of guitar tone.
On up drugs or down drugs?
Oh, up for up sure. You listen to the album and it's still very, very energetic, I must say. And Steve Cetro, the singer, I mean, he does his job. There's nothing special there. But the riffing, man, is just all over the place. And all the songs are bangers.
My favorite one. In a good way?
Yes.
Not all over the place.
No. My favorite song, or favorite riff, I would say. I mean, there's a lot of good riffs. The Years of Death and Dying. If you listen to that intro riff, it's basically, it's just so stupid. Like, it's a stupid riff. You know, standard metal.
Okay.
It reminds me of some older Tempo of the Dam songs as well. But it's just so caveman.
Okay, that yeah.
I immediately love it.
Down to the basic.
Oh, yeah, it's so basic. And you just listen, and it just gives you this. That's bass right there. It's just, I mean, the single Clickbait is also good, but The Years of Death and Dying.
Can you play that for us? I would like to hear that.
Okay. The Years of Death and Dying. Okay, let's see. I hope it's out. 3 weeks ago, it's out. Yes. I mean, it's so caveman.
You have to do that.
I mean, this song is made for people over 40. Let's just say that.
Yay! It's for us.
I mean, there's nothing special about this. But the production is like, it's just so good. And it's so modern. It reminds me a lot of Blacklist from Tempo Today.
Yeah.
And I love that song. You got your name to my blacklist. But you're I really hope she's not taking a shit or something. Or puking.
Just
anyways,
suspicious.
Persona non grata, 8 out of 10 for me. You would probably enjoy working out to this album. Let's just say that. Okay?
I'll try it next time.
Yes, you should try it next time for sure. 8 out of 10, Exodus, Persona non grata.
But it's not out yet?
It's out the 19th of November.
So I need to wait for a week.
Yes.
Okay.
All right, so for next 2 weeks album review that we're going to do, we're going to challenge ourselves and listen to a new album. I have two albums. I haven't decided
let me know.
I haven't decided which one we would review. One album is Limp Bizkit, Still Sucks, which is new. And
is it called Still Sucks?
It's called Still Sucks. The other album is the new Mastodon album, Hushed and Grim.
Okay.
So maybe you get to pick. Which one do you like to listen to?
I mean,
I've heard great things about both.
I'm not the biggest Limp Bizkit freak, so maybe I'll just have the Mastodon one.
Okay. It's 1.5 hours long.
Wow.
So it's a lot to listen to.
Okay.
You have to invest, okay? I just listened to a couple of songs while working out. No, you have to listen to the whole album a lot.
Okay. So how long is the other one?
Let me see. It's 32 minutes long.
That is way better.
Okay, you want to do Limp Bizkit Still Sucks?
Yeah, let's
good.
Do the Still
and
Sucks.
And I'll review Mastodon, the new
maybe
album.
Maybe it's good for me to,
I think it's good.
try to really listen to it.
You're probably going to enjoy it. I haven't listened too much to it, but that riff that Wes played there, that's an amazing riff. That's all I know.
It's going to be there?
It's going to be there. That's from the album. So
now I look forward to it.
Yeah, I'm also looking forward to checking out the new Mastodon. I listened to the first song and it's a banger. And yeah, I'm not the biggest Mastodon fan. I haven't listened too much to Mastodon. I like the previous album. I want to listen more to them. So this is a great opportunity for me to check out some Mastodon. What do you want to? She's on the computer now. Oh, she went. Oh, shit. I'll try this. Disappointment. All right. So that's the album reviews for you right there. Thank you. All right. Question of the day from Walmart Pizza. Zach, he's asking, question for Luis. I've seen a picture that Ola posted recently of yourself, your son, and your daughter, and I noticed something. Both of your kids are really tall. My mom went through a similar thing wherein her husband and all three of her boys all eventually ended up being taller than her, leaving her to be the shortest in the house. My question for you is, are you prepared for that to become a reality?
I mean, our son is gonna be taller than me. Very soon.
Question is he gonna be taller than me? Maybe.
That is a question. You know, my dad is kind of tall, about your height. But my mom is kind of short, so I still have some taller jeans.
You have taller jeans.
Yes, not denim jeans. Do you pronounce it the same? Jeans?
Yeah, it's jeans.
Just weird.
Great jeans. I have great jeans on me right now.
I have great jeans from my father's side. Yeah. No, but I mean, yeah, I'm prepared that our son is gonna be taller than me, maybe even taller than his dad. But my daughter, our daughter, that's a question. Yeah.
It doesn't matter as long as they're happy. You know, that's all I care about.
But am I prepared? That was the question. Yes.
He's already getting there.
I am prepared. He's like this height. I mean, now he's 11.
It's gonna be a tall boy. It's gonna be a tall boy.
It's gonna go fast.
It's gonna gotta go fast.
Gotta go fast.
Yeah.
Gotta go fast.
No.
What was the picture?
I don't know. I didn't post
a
picture.
I mean, we don't post any pictures.
I don't post
of
any
pictures.
Maybe it was something from behind, maybe.
Maybe.
That where I didn't show their faces.
Yeah.
Or Zach. Maybe it was on the Discord.
Yeah, maybe.
That's out of boundaries for a lot of people, let's just say that. Anyway, that's the question from Walmart Pizza, Zach Moraccielli. thank you. All right, since we haven't talked anything about anything, I thought we would check out some of the memes. Don't worry about these mice, all that shit that's here. That's just temporary. We have 3,300 memes here to check out.
Oh my god.
G-E-B-D-A-E. Did I see this one before? Staying in goddamn tune. The G string always goes out of tune.
Okay.
So that's the guy. That's so the G string right there. He's not holding on to the whatever they're holding on to.
Oh yeah, he's pretending
yeah,
to
the
be there with everybody else.
What a madman. PP very soft.
Okay. Let's.
Oh, that's great. Oh,
let's look at that.
Tell me a riff that gives you the space.
Yeah, that was the one.
The Exodus riff.
Yeah.
I need to walk into town and find a bathroom. I'm dying for a shit. Take my keys and go in the van. And it goes in the van.
I'm going.
Great.
Okay.
What my pedal board sees when I'm adjusting my delay and reverb. That's actually very accurate. When you like, you
that
you
looks
hold
very
on your
cute. Yeah.
And he has a Fender Mustang too. It's nice. 2020 has been hard on all of us, Christina Aguilera.
Yeah.
Accurate. Jacobs by Mark Jacobs for Mark by Mark Jacobs in collaboration with Mark Jacobs for Mark by Mark Jacobs. That's actually pretty clever. I like that. Why does Aussie look like a lesbian grandma that's so proud of her grandson? Well, drugs, exactly. I was just about to say drugs is the reason. Finally, I found a meme that won't offend anyone.
Yeah.
Congratulations. Did we laugh a lot? No?
No,
a little bit. It was a very sad story, let's just say that. But at least we killed some time. And yes. Okay, everyone. Thank you so much for watching. That was Mel Morning for you right there. I hope it's savable. The dog killed the computer, killed our spree. But that's okay. We still love her to death. That's what's important. I hope you guys have a great Sunday afternoon and Sunday with family and friends and your loved ones. And we'll see you next time, I guess. Thank you so much for joining in. Mel Morning. Goodbye.
Bye.